Residents and tourists are now demanding answers about when they can expect more emergency aid from the government, with thousands of people trapped without food, water and fuel this morning. I am joined by Minister for Water Resources and Emergency Management, David Littleproud. Minister, good morning to you. We heard from Robin just there. She's in Lake Conjola. The first water that she's had is half a bottle that she received from some of our crew. The anger, frustration and anxiety in these communities is palpable. What's your response?
Well, obviously, we stand ready to act and we're in action as we speak. The Defence Force was called in by the Victorian and New South Wales governments only in the last 24 hours in terms of ramping up our response, and that's not only through the air but through the sea, and they are on their way. And in fact, the initial briefings I had yesterday morning was that some of those assets weren't going to be there until Saturday, but because of the way that our Defence Force operates is that many of those assets will be there now, and in fact, there are helicopters around flying in supplies and moving a lot of personnel and people out at the direction of the state. So the Australian Defence Force takes its directions from state agencies. Otherwise, sometimes they can get in the road. So we stand ready to take supplies, whether they be water, food. There's obviously reports around some of the supermarkets running low, but we've been working with the supermarkets and understand that people shouldn't panic, that things are in hand and the state agencies are directing the Australian Defence Force assets as they see fit, and we'll continue to make sure that any assets that are required by state agencies are required. The Australian Defence Force is on standby for any further assets or any further calls.
But Minister, sorry, with respect, I've just got to cut you off there. As we heard directly from Robin, these communities don't have water. I would like to ask you, have you actually spoken to these petrol stations where our reporter Jonathan Kersley is up at Batemans Bay this morning? They are refusing to let people fill up their tanks if they don't pay. People don't have access to money because power's cut off, the ATMs aren't working, they're only taking cash. Is the government calling, are you calling these petrol stations and asking them to help these communities out so they can get out?
Well, obviously, that's the first I've heard of individual cases. And we work through a chain of command where the states own the operational management and they ask us to support them. We stand ready to support them in any way. And that's why the Defence Force has been called in. But you've got to understand that the operational management of the states need to be given some space. And sometimes the Defence Force can get in the road. And that's why now, once it's safe, the fires are starting to abate only for the next couple of days. Can the Defence Force get in and start to drop water and supplies? We can't put more people in harm's way until the fires have abated. The state agencies can make assessments that it's safe to get people in, and that's also around power. And I know that they're working as quickly as they can, and telecommunications. And as it becomes safe and they get people on the ground to make those assessments and then repairs, then they're done. But obviously it's a dangerous situation, and we've lost nearly 20 lives already. We don't want to have a knee-jerk reaction and get people in there and put people in harm's way. We've got to be calm and methodical. The Army and state agencies are on their way. We just need to make sure it's safe for everybody and how we deliver that. There's still smoke around and getting air support. And it's not just helicopters, it's fixed wing aircraft that the Army is also complementing all the work that state agencies are doing
as
well.
But Minister, on that, I understand you say it can't be a knee-jerk reaction, and I do understand it takes time to deploy the military and the Defence Force, but these are coastal towns that we know are very popular at Christmas time. Thousands of tourists go to that area. We've had bushfires burning across New South Wales and Victoria for months now. Are you happy with how both the federal government agencies, emergency agencies and state agencies have come together and prepared for this?
Oh, totally. Our fire commissioners are some of the best in the world. When I first
Sorry, Minister, I don't think anyone's denying that. I'm asking, are you happy with the government's response to this, what's now become a humanitarian crisis? No one is arguing that our volunteers and our New South Wales and Victorian firefighters are doing a remarkable job.
Well, our response is that the direction of those fire commissioners, those experts, not politicians. We listen to the fire commissioners from all around the country. They come together. In fact, when I became minister, the first advice I got was that we were going to have a protracted and longer fire season, and which we have, and they prepared for that. So we take the direction from the experts, and as soon as they have called on ADF assets, the federal government has responded. In fact, within a matter of minutes sometimes, that any request that's come, ADF assets have been ready to be deployed. And we've stood ready. The Defence Minister and I have been working and wargaming to make sure that even Army reservists are ready if the state agencies called upon us.
Minister, just quickly, you're in Queensland at the moment, even though the Prime Minister copped a lot of criticism for being in Hawaii. When are you going to visit these communities?
Well, when it's safe, you don't need politicians running around taking up the time of fire commissioners getting briefings. I can do that and make sure that I'm ready to pivot into these fire grounds, as is the Prime Minister. But we need to make sure that the experts and the professionals get to do their job, not look for cheap frontline photos of politicians running around. We'll get there, but only when we're told it's safe and we get out of the hair of these professionals, because we've got another spike day on Saturday and there's a lot of preparation that these people need to do. And the best thing we can do is let them do their job and provide them with the resources they need. And that's what the federal government will do through the Australian Defence Force. And any further requests they need will be acted upon immediately.
All right, Minister David Littleproud, thank you very much for your time this morning.